might do that. That 1A run that I was working on before. Free. Got it? Memorized? Free. Alright, I might work up from a lower key. Gonna set it to auto go up in pitch. To 2 reps at each key. Down 6 to origin. I'm gonna slow it down to 15 so I'm really accurate. Free. original. So that was at 50% speed from down 6 up to original key, 2 reps on each, one with him, one without him. Now, why do that? Because you're training from low to high, and training from low to high very gradually by doing one key at a time is what builds your ability to gradually stretch your voice and go higher and higher in a safe way without going too quick, jumping into a new range too quick. It's very gradual, it stretches it, builds the strength on each key. Also builds your voice, the strength on the quality of your notes and your ability to execute your notes well through across your whole range, your whole mid to upper range, because you're training all of those keys. Secondly, why the 50%? The 50% because it forces you to hold notes for longer and keep them really stable, taking out any shakiness from your voice and helping you be able to stay really steady. Every note, hit every note really accurately, and change between notes really accurately, because this is a fast run. Even 50% is pretty fast because it's advanced. Helps you to change notes really accurately while staying very stable. At the same time, it builds that strength where you are able to sound really like you're effortless when you're doing something, because you can hold each note very comfortably. Alright guys, I'm Rashid Hayek, currentbeastsinglessons.com. That's how I'll train something, a run, alright? Next, I will do speed training, where I will go from slow to fast. So I might actually do that now. I feel like I've got a bit more energy to go. I'll put on an auto rep, so after one loop with each speed, increase by 5%. Let's roll with that. I'm going to take off the pitch changing. Alright, so it's going to be an original key. I'm going to go from 50% up to 100%. And it's going to go up in 5% increments. I'm going to do it at original key. Now I'm going to do it in 10% increments. fast, can't quite do it at 100, sound a bit shaky. That's the point of the slow training, it gets rid of the shakiness, so you gradually get faster and faster. So I'm at around about 90%, that's pretty good. Try without him. Free! Going as fast as I can, so a little bit shaky. Say if I try to do it without him and as fast as I can but accurately. Free, yeah, yeah, oh no, no. Oh, it was about the same. Alright, there you have it. So range development and speed development. Two important parts of training your voice, whether it's a run or whether it's just even normal lyrics. They're two mandatory parts that you've got to train if you want to get better. And they're separate to learning it. So I already learned the run. I've already got it memorized. I already did three sessions previously where I memorized this run. They were devoted to memorizing the run. Now these sessions are focused specifically on range training and speed training, which is the next step after you've memorized something. So this doesn't just apply to runs, guys, it applies to anything. It's the same concepts. I've used the concepts for all my training. Train memorization, which is where you learn the notes first. Then you train range, and then you train the speed. Okay? That's it. Those three things, when you apply them to any element, lyrics, falsetto, any melody, runs, blend, high notes, it doesn't matter what you're learning, which element of music you're learning. You apply memorization, then range training and speed training to all of them. You will be, so by range encompasses, it includes volume as well, like when you're training range. You train that way and you're gonna get the most progress that is possible with your voice. You're going to continue to see progress until you reach your goal, or until you get closer. You're just going to get closer to your goal. Will you ever reach the goal? I don't know. Everyone's range, and we'll never know exactly where people will reach. But if it's like, we never know exactly how fast you're going to be able to go, or how like accurately, or how high your range is going to go, or low your range is going to go, how much you're able to memorize. But in myself, I haven't seen a limit yet. I haven't seen a wall where it's like, oh, I'm not making progress anymore. It hasn't happened yet. If you train this way, I promise you, you're just gonna keep making progress. And the journey is the fun part. Will you reach the goal? I don't know, but you will get closer to the goal. I guarantee you will gradually keep getting closer. Your progress will not stop. In my case, I have reached my goals in some areas, like vibrato, I've reached my goals. I've reached my goals in many runs that I've been able to do. I've reached my goals in pitch accuracy on lyrics of songs. I've reached my goals in range goals that I had before. And it keeps improving. And I just keep finding harder and harder things to do. All right, guys. See ya.